What's happening?
I don't know. What is happening?
Am I embarrassing you?
Marry me.
Can we at least talk about last night?
It's 10 years wasted.
You should get dressed. We gotta get on the road.
You dumped me. You can't possibly think you're coming to my sister's wedding.
I'm the king of the ushers.
You're not coming. You ready for this?
No.
Neither am I. Run.
Hey! Oh my God!
Hey! Hey!
Favorite couple.
What do we tell people?
Maybe we could just not tell anyone.
Just until the wedding is over.
3 days.
3 days.
Rick Hong here for Hollywood First Look. Today, I'm with Laura Jackman and Jeff Rosenberg, and we are talking their movie, We Broke Up. So I wanted to tell you too that I am very familiar with a version of this story because senior year homecoming dance, I kind of had to do this with an ex-girlfriend and we decided we were going to go together. So congratulations. I enjoyed watching this.
Oh, that's
Rick,
great.
I don't know if you know this, but your ex-girlfriend is the one who pitched the story to us. And that's what happened. And we were like, this sounds like a great movie and we'll tell Rick this before it comes out.
Where did the idea hatch from? I'm hoping that it didn't happen to either of you, but.
We wanted to write a story about this couple, but we wanted it to be very even-handed and feel like both this man and this woman were very well represented. So that's where the collaboration came from.
Essentially what it was taking, you know, in terms of Doug to myself and Lori to Laura, there was some similarity in terms of just what our feelings were on relationships and how they're defined and what people want in relationships. We were able to bring that real lived experience to the screenplay as we started writing.
Jeff, so when you get to set, you know, like clearly like when the two of you sit down and you know, like there's the white page and yeah, exactly. You're talking, you're collaborating, you write the script, everything is there like in dialogue, the scenes. But then as a director, when you get there, do you allow for some like improv and change?
With something like this, because both Laura and I have playwriting backgrounds and it had specific dialogue. For the most part, we would usually try to shoot something close to the page to start. And then if it went other places, we would let it go other places. Also, you know, improv's a muscle that some actors are extremely comfortable with, where other actors, it's not necessarily part of their DNA. And there's nothing right or wrong about that. It's just everyone has different processes.
You guys got an amazing cast. I mean, yeah, William Jackson Harper, Aya Cash, Tony Cavallaro, Sarah Bolger, Perry Gilpin, who she's so pretty still, like beautiful and everything. I was like, man, she could actually be the Aya Cash character. I don't think she's aged.
My sense of relief with how fantastic of an actor Aya is. And then once Will was interested in doing it as well, because Aya was like the first person we offered the project to. She'd been on for a few years before we made it. The amount of pressure in terms of being able to deliver the film that we had in our heads gets alleviated so much
once
we know we have the two of them. I mean, you can look at the poster behind you. It was like once we had Will and I in the movie, it's like, let's just figure out their schedule, which thankfully ended a week before the pandemic started. And we just shot it right before and we just, attacked the movie.
One of the best parts of the movie was the game sequence. So when you two sit down, Laura, I don't know if you both of you are writing everything in detail or if you guys already had an idea of like how the games are supposed to be and everything, or you're like, we'll figure it out when we get to set.
It's so funny. I think the actual line in the script, I think it's very, very sparing on the page. I think it's just sort of like a list of some of the games and what, like sort of the emotional tone, beginning, middle, and end of what Will and I as characters are sort of going through during that sequence.
That one I went to set very confident. Like that is within my element of like, I enjoy when you wind up in situations that are improvisational, not just from writing, not just from a performance standpoint, but from like writing, from production design, from camera, from everything. The trucks that were in our shot, that added stress. That was not planned. So the whole thing, you know, I'm an assistant director. I've been assistant director for a while. So for me, you know, with Maura Kelly, our assistant director, and then with Amelia Steele, our production designer, with our whole team, everyone was just sort of on board and ready to go. And so it really was just like, our production design team kind of just dropped a bunch of stuff on the field. And it was like, I could just run around and be like, okay, we had the red team, we had the blue team. And it's like, okay, now we're going to do dizzy bat races. Now we're going to do tug of war. Let's do tug of war again, but this team wins. Let's do tug. And we just sort of ran around and just shot an absurd amount of material.
The movie is We Broke Up. You can catch it in theaters April 16th and video on demand April 23rd. Until next time, I'm Rick Hong, and you've been watching Hollywood First Look.
I want to spend my life with you. I want to have kids together. I want us to get old and die together. Isn't that what you want?